If you look at the bar graph, what you'll find is it's a much finer representation of the data. By pooling together multiple data points into an individual bar, you can see that there's a much better way to really understand the dependence of cost to data. And while the bar doesn't give you the linear relationship, in fact, in this case, happens to be nonlinear, it really gives you a sense as you go up in house sizes, the cost increases, which wasn't obvious from looking at the individual data points. So what the bar chart does, it really helps you to pool together groups of data into a single bar and understand global trends. Such global trends might not be that important if you only have 6 data points, but imagine you have 60,000. With 60,000 data points, your scatter plot may look like this. And I can tell you, my hand isn't really able to draw 60,000 points. If you were to look at this data set, the individual data tell you very little. Jumping in X parameter by a tiny bit might make you jump in Y from here to here, down to here to here, at some point down to here. Yet a bar graph can really help you understand the data. So clearly, one of the things that a statistician does is to use cumulative tools such as bar graphs to gain an understanding of the underlying data. So let me ask you, are bar charts cool? Just check one of the two answers.